segregation, and education.
The enforced act of separation on the basis of racial group or color skin.
According to the Civil Rights Project at UCLA, minorities across the country are more likely to attend majority-minority schools than they were a generation ago.
We're students from BCC, and we wanted to take a look into our local East Bay high schools to see how relevant segregation in education is today. We interviewed several teachers and took comments from students to get a better perspective on what students and teachers are experiencing today.
Definitely there's some diversity there, but there is a clear majority group, absolutely. Latinos make up about 60% of our students here.
My classes reflect the ethnic breakdown of the school in general, which would be that the majority of the students in my classes are Hispanic or Latino origin. I also teach a sheltered English class, which is English language learners. And so the majority of students in there are also Hispanic or Latino. But it's also very diverse too, you know, from Chinese to Cambodian to Filipino. And then in my mainstream classes, it would break down like 60% would be Latino, about 20% African American, and then the rest would be a mix of other races.
I really don't tend to see a lot of students being favored academically over others at a per high school level, but I do see it within the district.
In my own class, I can't really speak to this. I like to think that I'm very fair with all of my students. I know that if you look at the referrals and the detentions that go into our front office, that you're gonna see that it's African American males that are the ones that are receiving the most referrals, and it's just males in general too that are receiving them. So I'm not exactly sure if you would call it favoritism. It might be that teachers are reacting differently to those students.
Students have name called, but to me, I don't think it's been, I wouldn't really call that racism or discrimination. It's just, you know, kids mouthing off each other, and I certainly have not noticed any teachers.
I would say that just from overhearing kids talk, you do hear like, that teacher's racist, and you don't really know if the students really mean it or if they're frustrated or that sort of thing. What I do see as a teacher leader in the school that is involved with the district as well is that there is an idea in this community, if you are Asian or white, that you should not go to the school and that you should be going to our sister high school. And so what I see is, and we've called it like Asian flight, and so if Asian students do get placed here, that they request to be transferred over there. So what I think that clearly is racism on the part that there's this general idea that if black and brown kids are in a school, that you don't, that it's not going to be a good school to go to, and you should go to a different school. So that is what I really see.
Segregation, I think the segregation in terms of economic status, that's very prevalent, of course. So if you have district, like a school like this, in a district that's more lower performing compared to a district in Lafayette or Pleasanton or somewhere like that, it's going to be, the disparity is going to be huge, absolutely huge.
I think it's still extremely relevant today. You compare this high school with what goes on in Piedmont and you will see two completely different worlds.
Absolutely. There's schools that get a lot more funding, they have a lot more money. It's not fair, it's not equitable in any way, shape, or form.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I think that if we do not address the segregation that is happening in public schools, that we as a society are just damning ourselves to a future that looks really bleak and that is not serving those that really need it. And the fact that our public schools are blamed for so many things that are happening, it just goes to show that, you know, when you look at public schools, it's a reflection of the way that society is working right now. And I think that we just really need to hold up the mirror and really be thoughtful about what's happening, because it's not a good thing at all.